fine. All right. So there was a young man, okay, from New Zealand. So his ambition was something which we call as unsurmountable. Unsurmountable means even the greats have tried that, but they haven't found success in it. Okay. Okay, let me take you all around approximately 100 years back. Okay. Of course, if the doubt is on, Lakshita, your doubt is on English means, you can ask during English. Okay. Now it's life skills class. So look here, I'm taking you all back. So we all know what is Mount Everest, right? Which is the highest peak in the world? Even a third standard kid will say, no, Mount Everest is the highest peak in this world. Okay. Now it's very easy. People go like they are going for trekking and they come back. But literally scaling Mount Everest is highly, highly, highly a very hard target. Today we have the GPS, the government, the Nepal government, as well as the Bhutan government has the tracking system. They know in which part of the mountain, which traveler is there. They have that accountability. They know what happens there. Yes, obviously it is dangerous also, but not that dangerous when the two greats scaled the Mount Everest. Literally, if I take you all back 100 years ago, where we did not have GPS, we did not have drone system, we did not even have proper helicopters which can float above the altitude of Mount Everest. So we all know, a helicopter, it can only fly up to a certain altitude. If it goes more than that, the air pressure will make the helicopter jerk initially. If they prolong with their journey, even the pressure is going to just blast that helicopter. So that's how, and it's very high, right? The altitude, it is the highest peak. Mind you, none of them have scaled it before that. Plenty of them have gone on top. They have tried scaling it. Some of them have come back. We can't do it because of excessive cold. Then a lot of landslide will happen there. So snows will come like a big tsunami. It's known as the Himalayan tsunami. What will happen? So plenty of them die there. Itself. Nobody is there to carry them. Once they go on top, if they die on top, that's it. That's the end of them. They'll be there only. Okay. Such a dangerous thing. And this Edmund Hillary from New Zealand, he wanted to scale his this Mount Everest. Okay. While he came to Nepal, he had to take some few people along with him because scaling Mount Everest is not that easy, no? They should have a cylinder, okay? Oxygen cylinder. Then the kit, okay? They have to wear these gloves, the boot where you don't get your frostbite, etc., etc. They went up to a certain distance. Six of them accompanied him. So all of them said, see here, Mount Everest, we don't know where it is. After this, I can't walk at all because it is very, very, very high in altitude. Like that and all, they demotivated him. They doesn't want him to go. See, we must be happy that we are alive. We'll go down. We are in the South Pole. South Pole is the southern edge of Mount Everest. More you have to walk. You have to walk around 6 to 7 hours to reach the edge of Mount Everest. Only till that, humans have gone. Fine. 8,848 meters high. It's not a easy job to scale. Thank you, Nitin. Okay. Now see, so they have to go there. Everyone was at their back foot. But this Edmund Hillary was reluctant to go. He wanted to create history. One person befriended him. He wanted to support this Edmund Hillary. That person is a Nepali. He's a Sherpa. Okay, Sherpa is a local tribe. Okay, they only rare goats. So that man is known as Tenzing Norgay. Fine, he's from Nepal. So what did he do? Sir, I will come along with you. Let us scale the mountain. It wasn't an easy job. But finally, they went to the edge of Himalayas. So many obstacles. See, you will have those cornices hanging. Cornices are nothing but sharp eyes. Little bit if it melts means that sharp eyes, no, it's very strong. If it comes and pierces your head means that's it. Like that. slippery ice will be there, very rock solid ice are there. And then you have ice, no, it will be like sand. If you keep your leg down, your leg will sink inside. Sometimes it might be a steep also. Sometimes you might fall down. Plenty of dangers were there. And landslide, mountain slide. From the top, if it comes, means we can't run this side or that side. Because they had to climb through the rope. So many obstacles they crossed. But today, if I ask y'all, who were the first men to scale Mount Everest? If I ask y'all, y'all will say, Edmund Hillary and Tenzing Norgay. So see, who are the second to come there? We don't know. Third, we don't know. Who are the first Indian? Literally, we have to Google it, and then only we will get it. History only remembers the people who have scaled it first. The hard work, the grit made them create history. Okay. So why am I telling this story to you all? Sir, the story we know, sir. Why are you telling this? There is a reason behind it. Let me share the screen for today's life skill class. Okay. So the topic is simple. Here comes a topic. It's resilience. Resilience. What is being resilient, my dear children? Here comes the real meaning of it. Resilience is the ability to bounce back. From where you have to bounce back? From the water? Bouncing back from your problem. If at all a problem arises, what we have to do? You have to face it, right? If at all you have lost in something, oh my God, I have lost. Why should I come back? If you think like that, you are a loser. Let me bounce back and win over it. That is the mantra of being successful, dear children. Okay. See, yeah. You have to take on difficult challenges and still find meaning in life. Life will always give you all difficult challenges. It is not a bed of roses, my dear children. Always your life is going to be difficult. But what we have to do, we should not be like as if you were born with a silver spoon, you enjoyed your life and you die happily. That's not life. Okay, you have to imprint your history in this particular world. At least four of them should think about you. If you live a normal life, what is going to happen? If you die, your children will remember you at least once in a year. They burn a candle, they offer puja, like this and all it will happen. Your grandchildren, they will have your photo in your house. After that, what will happen to your great-grandchildren? They don't even know your name. Who is this? Hey, it is your great-grandfather. Oh, I see. Okay. Their children, obviously, they will forget you. So you will also be dead and decay like your dead body. Is it life? Do you all think it is life? Definitely not. We have to face difficult challenges right from this particular age. You should not step backward. If Edmund Hillary would have stepped backward, what would have happened there? Definitely, he wouldn't have been the first person to scale Mount Everest. Even this Tenzing Norgay, he wouldn't have hardly thought that he is this, he is also equally the first person to scale that Mount Everest. At least Edmund Hillary was a rich man. This person, still we think about him. He is a Sherpa from Nepal. One who made his country proud. Resilience made it possible, dear children. They respond positively to difficult situation. If a difficult situation comes, this one, how am I going to win over this? If you think like that, there it is, you lose, my dear children. Take it as a piece of cake. So plenty of your type, no? Grammar is a piece of cake for us, sir. So like that only. You have to respond positively to difficult situation. Rise above adversity. You have to rise above your adversity. I can't do it. If you think like that, that's all. You become a loser. Cope when things look bleak. When things look very, very, very bleak, very weak, you can't do anything. If a situation comes like that, don't give up, dear children. You have to cope when things look bleak. You have to work hard to make it a little bit positive. Got it? Tap into hope. Never give up your hope at all. Okay, these points are very important, dear children. Transform unable situation into wisdom, insight, and compassion. So you think some unfavorable situation is happening to you. Oh my God, why is this happening to me alone? Why is God testing me? Literally, God tests a person to make them very strong, him or her very strong. And women know, particularly your resilience is something which is extraordinary, dear children. So, actually, by birth itself, women have upper hand. So, the resilience is something which is an inborn quality for women. Okay? Until your death, right from your birth until your death, somewhere down the line, y'all are what? Y'all are raging a war against odds. Okay? The failures, difficult challenges, everything. Men are also not that inferior. Men will always, man is a creature who is born to rage a lot of war. Okay, you have to study well, you have to go for a good job, and then you have to settle down your children. Plenty of jobs, duties. We call them as duties. So they are difficult challenges only. So anyway, men as well as women, definitely will have to have that inborn quality as resilience. Okay, down the line, those who are very weak, those who are not fighting their own battle, are unfit to stay in this particular world. Obviously, my dear children, endure. Endurance is one of the qualities which makes you fight against your difficult challenge. Okay, so resilience is very important for each and every one of you. Okay. So these are the abilities. So these are resilience. Resilience is nothing but when some difficult challenges are coming towards you, definitely at that particular time, you should not step backward. You have to be very smart enough to accept it, to fight over it and win it. So resilience is something which is highly inborn. Okay. What else are the abilities? Yeah. And what are the qualities? That resilience is that quality that allows some people to be knocked down by life and come back stronger than ever. So sometimes life knocks us down, right? So y'all, I'm not sure, y'all are very young enough to be knocked down by your life. If y'all say, I am knocked down by life, definitely I would say it is not really true. There are days to come. There are challenges to be faced. Today your life is something which is very safe. Okay, you're like hatchling. Y'all are in the safe hands of your parents. Your parents are going to be very resilient. So they are highly resilient in protecting y'all from all the ill odds. But life will open up at some part of time. At that time, definitely y'all may be knocked down by the life. But what y'all have to do? Oh my God, life has knocked me down. I can't do anything. I quit my life. If y'all think like that, you're the number one loser. History will never remember you. That's very important, dear children. They have to come back stronger than ever. So that is the quality of resilience. And each and every one of y'all should have that quality, my dear children. Fight for your right. Come back stronger than ever. If you think mathematics, oh my God, it's not my cup of tea. Just an example, just an instance, I'm saying mathematics. It's not my cup of tea. All the other subjects I'm good. Mathematics alone is not coming to me. If you think like that, what is going to become? What is going to happen? That negative intent will put you down very low. So it shows down in your academic. What you have to do? Only mathematics, no? All the subjects I have mastered. Let me master mathematics also. If you think like that, if you work on throughout it with positive intent, definitely you're going to come out of the chapter. Each and every subject like that, my dear children. The subjects, it's only for school level. I'm talking about subjects which are going to travel only up to a certain extent with y'all. But this resilient quality, you know, which y'all develop, which y'all maintain while doing some hard work, definitely that quality will never put you submerged into problems. Okay? If you are very resilient, you will have that positive intent. You will come out of any problems in your life at any time. Okay, now see, Resilience is best understood as a process. It's a process, dear children. It is often mistakenly assumed to be a trait of individual, an idea more typically referred to as resilience. Okay, it's 100% with an individual mind.